Preview. Preview.
Well, Russia said that the United States plans to strike Damascus and pledges military response if they do. Out of Moscow, Reuters is reporting over at Yahoo News that Russia said today it had informed that the United States planned to bomb the government quarter in Damascus. Now, you know Damascus is about 70% destroyed right now, ruinous heap. The only place that's not is where the government of Bashar al-Assad and the government employees and families, where they all live, basically, in the protected area. And Russia says the United States is going to bomb that area on an invented pretext and said it would respond militarily if it felt if Russian lives were threatened by such an attack. Now, Valery Gerstaramov, head of Russia's general staff, said Moscow had informed that the rebels in an enclave of eastern Ghouta were planning to fake a chemical weapon attack, a false flag, against civilians and blame it on the Syrian army. He said the United States intend to use that fake attack false flag attack as a pretext to bomb the government quarter in nearby Damascus, where he said Russian military advisors, Russian military police, and Russian ceasefire monitors were based. In the event of a threat to the lives of our servicemen, Russia's armed forces will take retaliatory measures against the missiles and launchers used in such an attack, said the Russian general. And he went on to say that he did not say when the alleged attack would take place or provide any details, evidence to back this assertion. Russia has previously accused rebels in Syria preparing to use toxic agents in eastern Ghouta so they could later accuse Damascus of employing chemical weapons. Damascus denies these Western allegations that the government forces have used chemical weapons. And U.S. Ambassador to the United Nations, Nikki Haley, warned on Monday that Washington remains prepared to act if we must. If the United Nations Security Council fails to act on Syria as the Syrian army's onslaught in eastern Ghouta continues to be unabated. So now it's going to be a he said situation. In other words, they're going to use chemical weapons. And either side, according to this report, Russia says the United States would then take advantage of that situation and blame it on Bashar al-Assad of Syria and the Russians of gassing the people. On the other hand, the Russians are saying it's the Americans, not gassing, but the Americans would wait till the rebels gas their own people in Damascus, and then the U.S. would come in and bomb Assad's, the area, the governmental residential areas of Syria and where the Russians are staying as well. So here we go, guys. It's uglier and uglier. And now a propaganda war is going on to justify physical force and lethal force by both sides. So it's getting, he said, it's getting uglier by the minute how we need this to end. But there's a struggle for who's going to control the oil in Syria. There's no doubt about this. Turkey wants to control the oil that's up there where the Kurds are living, but that's ExxonMobil that owns that oil. And of course, the United States has trained the Kurds to protect themselves. And we even got 2,000 special forces up there to help protect the Kurds and those oil fields. But Turkey wants them. Now, meanwhile, other oil fields, the United States wants to control, and there's other oil fields the Russians want to control, along with the Iranians. So now it's not a, it's all about just who gets to control which parcels of land, all under somehow supposedly under the government of Assad. This is really, really ugly, and it's nowhere near being done. It's so many innocent people have died. So many have died in this needless slaughter. ISIS, who originally wanted to control the whole thing, they've been pretty well stomped in the head and run out of town. But the factions of it, remnant of it, are just looking for new groups to join. But they're not, you know, you're never going to kill that spider. That ugliness will continue until Christ returns. Yeah.